Hello, Gems and Germs, and welcome to my next episode of my Minecraft Let's Play. I don't have any more special name than that yet, but hey, there we go. So, I've got my little house temporarily built. I'd like to make it nicer than this as I gain in materials and things. I'd like to put a cover over my patio and, you know, make some columns here and whatnot, but I have added another couple of mods. We have this wonderful door, which, as Wayla will tell you, is from Carpenter's Blocks. I put in the door, and then you can cover it with any texture you want. So I made it glass. It's kind of cool, so you can see through it. And then I've also used a carpenter's pressure plate here and covered it, so it's practically invisible. I think you can even make it slightly more invisible than that. I don't remember, but it's a pretty nice little piece. You know, it doesn't stand out like the standard pressure plate. So it's very nice, and I enjoy being able to look straight out my door. I can see who's at the door before I open it. So we just have a little basic place here. I haven't separated it into rooms yet. I haven't added things. I brought my bed over. Everything else is behind this little secret door. As you can see, there's nothing to see from this side, which is another really cool aspect of the carpenter's block. Like this door, I've covered this one so it looks like it's cobblestone. Now it does look a little fishy at the moment, and you can, you know, come over here and go, well, you've got a something there. But you know, as I stretch this place out a little bit and add some rooms, It will be a little less obvious that there's a door hiding right there. So I've moved my bed. Haven't added too much over here. Here's the quartz grindstone. For those of you that haven't used Applied Energistics, it allows you to double your ores, many of your ores. So, for example, I've got my iron ore in here, and then you spin this little baby around, you use your right click, and it takes about 8 rotations. You can just hold down your right mouse button, and it'll turn and turn. And eventually it creates 2 iron dust out of each iron ore. And you can look over. Nope, these ones are done. Wow, that was fast. So you can take your iron dust and you toss it in here, and it will cook up your iron dust just like your iron ingots, or sorry, the iron ore, the little iron blocks that are in here. But each dust is worth 1 ingot. So instead of getting 1 for 1, you're now getting 2 for 1, and it's a way better deal. And I know that I'm wasting the rest of the heat there. No need for the comments. I did the same thing with my gold. So I have a lot more gold than I did before, which is extremely helpful. Those of you with mods that need gold know. And it allowed me to get my thermometer really going here, and a couple of other items that I needed gold for. I have also made my thermionic fabricator, which was necessary to get the parts for all of my farm blocks. And so we've got the farm out here all set up and ready to show off. Oh yeah, and the back side of the door. If you use the carpenter's blocks and you make actual blocks, see if I have any left or if I used them all up. Here you go. If you use actual blocks, when you put them down and use them like as a wall, you can make one surface, so like you could make the outside cobblestone, and then you could make the inside of the wall a completely different texture. So you could make the inside wood and the outside stone, or whatever you wanted to do, and it's quite fascinating and really ups your ability to change things around, because you can make the inside of your house look different than the outside of your house, like houses do. You know, if you got siding or stucco or whatever on the outside, usually the inside's a little different. So that's very cool. I did bring some cactus over here and started me a little cactus farm because the cactus is great for making pipe sealant, which is what I needed to help out with my little farm over here. Oh, I didn't grab dirt. Let's run back and grab dirt really quick. Run, little man. Ugh. Do you hate it when you miss the doorway? In here. We need some dirt. Oh, I need stuff. Crap, I can't remember. No, here. Oh, stop that. It's not gonna tell me, is it? Well, dang it. I know what it is I need, or maybe I just put the appetite in. Crap. I'll be right back. I'm gonna check on this. Give me just a second. We're going to cut here, and I'll be right back. And we're back. Okay, so I need sand and appetite, and that gives me fertilizer. Let's just get a stack. That's probably plenty. Okay, so we've got our fertilizer, and we are going to need something to plant. So let's start with some oak saplings, because I don't have any birch ones with me. Boy, you'd think I'd be completely prepared, but apparently I am not. So now back out to the farm. Now I didn't put it the last piece in so I could show you guys. I got the little farm and down in the little basement here. I've got my combustion engine and I've put some oil in it. I ran out to the desert and found some oil and it's currently full of water. I've got a pump here and I've got my little endless water supply that we all know and love. And so my pump sucks up water. It provides it to through the valve into the farm system, and it also supplies water down into my combustion engine to keep it cool. So we are pumping energy out of the combustion engine to power the farm. That way it'll chop down the trees itself. This is just a basic one with that'll just do trees. It'll chop down the trees itself, replant them, put the dirt down, use the fertilizer, it'll replace the dirt as necessary, all of that fun jazz. But then this also goes over and powers my pump. So I've got a nice little circular thing going on there. To keep everything hunky-dory. When I run out of oil, then I'll just run and grab some more buckets and bring it down until the future comes when I have a nice little fuel station set up that converts the oil to fuel, etc., etc. Now, the farm blocks, I've just done all of the basic ones except having a valve and having the gearbox for power. You that there are some other blocks you can add. Farm. So there is a control block. There's the gearbox. There's the valve. The valve is for water. The hatch is so that you can automatically get stuff in and out of the farm. So I'm fine with coming over and doing it manually for now. Eventually, I might want to take out one of these and put in a hatch block, and then you could pipe everything out and have it go into a chest for you. You could set up a whole sorting system and all of that fun stuff. And sun's gonna go down before we really get this going, which is somewhat annoying. Okay, so I needed the pipe sealant for those waterproof pipes to pump the water into the farm and to have water for my gearbox. We're gonna sleep here because it's gonna get dark in a second, and then I'll show off the farm. So maybe I'll just cut this scene again while we're waiting for the sun to go down. Okay, and the sun's back up, so we're gonna race over here. Alrighty, we have the last farm block. So, when you put in this last block, if everything has been done right, it's going to create a band. Boom, there we go. All right, so we're happy. So that means it's taken all of those individual blocks and turned them into a machine. And check it out, we got a tree farm. Oh, we're starting to fill up with water. That's weird. There must be water in the pipe. That's got to be what it is, because I don't have power. Yep, there's just water in the pipe, because this isn't running right now. See, it says error, because that doesn't have electricity. Yeah, so it's filling up the farm. Well, you go. So, I should close that door. Now, it needs stuff to plant, so we're going to give it some saplings. There we go. It needs dirt to put down, so we're going to give it some dirt. And you could put buckets of water in and fill it with water instead of piping water to it. I don't mind coming to get stuff out, that this is the output, but coming to put water in all the time would just be a massive pain. And we're going to put fertilizer. I thought we were going to put fertilizer. Oh, sorry. Let me grab the fertilizer instead of the appetite. And we put fertilizer in here. And that was weird. Something moved, but it doesn't have power, so it shouldn't be moving. Okay, we're going to power it up, and then we're going to run up and watch it, because this is fun. Ooh, look. It's made hummus. Let me get out of its way. Now, if I had made this a vegetable farm, as it was putting down the dirt, it would also put down water blocks. And we're just going to watch it for a minute here, because I don't know about you guys, but I always think this is just so cool. Watching things do the work for you. Now, as the saplings grow, they're going to grow into trees, and this will automatically chop them down. And as the saplings fall down, it will automatically collect the saplings and replant them. So, I don't know if I have enough bone meal to grow a tree. I left it back in there. Of course I left it back in there. But we are... Let's run over here and see if we can get a couple of birch saplings while we're waiting. Maybe. Come on, saplings. It's just not our sapling day, is it? Automatic tree farm, and not many saplings to plant. It will eventually fill itself up. As you guys know, the trees do make saplings, so... So you don't have to, you know, if you've only got a few saplings, just get it started, because and I think that the tree one is the easiest to set up. You don't have to make a circuit board and tell it to produce, you know, wheat or potatoes or whatever it is you want to do. You can, of course, but you we got saplings, but you don't have to is the real beauty of the machine. So eventually, oh look, one actually grew, and did you guys see that sapling fall? And it will have replanted it. Oh, another one fell, but I thought that one fell outside of the machine, but it got it. And then it will, if you set it up with all the right stuff, it will auto-harvest your potatoes, your carrots, whatever you want. You can even set it up so that each of these four quadrants is a different fruit, a different vegetable. With the fruit trees, you can set it up to harvest the fruit. There is a special rubber tree farm so that you can set it up and it won't chop down your trees. It will just harvest all the rubber sap out of it for you. And you can just come and you click in here and you grab your goodness and you're ready to go make you some copper cables or whatever else you're particularly making. 80% humidity. Oh, well, isn't that fascinating? Yeah, we know about that. Temperature, climate. Well, that's all cool. So far, one tree has grown, it looks like. And you can, like, oh. Yeah, so, oh, it's just because another one dropped. You can show up here at any time, and like we grabbed these couple of saplings, drop them in, and it's just going to pop them right out. One, two. There we go. There's our birch ones. And so stuff grows. I'm gonna run and grab some bones so I can make some bone meal and show you guys. So we'll be back in just a second. And we're back. Oh, hey, look, a tree has grown. And I didn't even need the bone meal. So if we watch here in just a second, it's gonna chop down the tree, and it doesn't matter if they're big ones or not. It'll chop them all the way, so it's quite useful. So you can just wander off for days, let it do its thing, and come back and collect all the wood. There it goes, and we'll find the wood inside. As you can see, it collects the apples for us as well. I did run and grab some more saplings as I came back. So we're just going to toss those in there. And some bone meal. We can, poof, watch this tree. Oh, there it goes. And it's planting saplings. And so it's all automated, and it'll eventually fill up the entire area with saplings. So at some point, the sapling area will fill up, and you'll have to take the saplings out as well. If I make it very far from my house, I'll usually put a few chests out here. So as I empty it, I can put them in. And then, of course, at a future point, you will throw in that hatch one we talked about, and pipe everything out automatically and just let it go to town. You won't have to come and get the wood from it. And so now you have an endless supply of wood that automatically takes care of itself. And you also then have an endless supply that you can turn into charcoal. So no more farming for obnoxious coal. So that's all for today's episode. I really have no idea what's in store for my next episode. Maybe we're going to take a closer look at some applied energistics stuff. I do need to set up my Thaumcraft stations to start doing some research for Thaumcraft, and make our house a little bit bigger. And maybe we'll set up another... another farm. At the moment, food has not been a problem because we've got these little farms out here. And I also added Natura or Nutura. I'm not sure how you guys all say it out there. I just go with the Natura. It's kind of like nature. Maybe I should say Natura, but that sounds weird, doesn't it? So I have started collecting some extra seeds. I've got this little cotton plant growing here. It's growing very slowly. And some barley, and I haven't come across any of the new fruits that are supposed to be added yet. See if I have it with me. No, I added another mod here. Maybe it's with the Applied Energistics one. As you guys will notice, I enjoy the mods. I like making Minecraft be all it can be. Now, expanding what's there. I mean, that's what mods are for. Adds a whole lot of nifty new features and functionality and things to play with. These little things from Applied Energistics, way out over there, can show you on my map. I found a right here. The meteorite crashed here and here. So I dug out a little bit of it and found the chest. There are chests hiding in the middle of meteors, and it had those. I didn't see those eerie spots. It has those little things that are supposed to help you make some machines later. So I don't know what to do with those yet, but it's going to be cool to find out. So we'll see you on the next episode. Thanks for watching. As always, if you liked the video, please click like. Please click subscribe. Share it with a friend. Share it with a neighbor. Share it with your spouse. But have them watch it again so I get another count. No, I'm just kidding. You don't have to do that. But thanks, guys. I'll catch you on the flip side.